Absolute Radio backstage at the Isle of Wight Festival with Alexandra Burke.
Hey, I'm good, thank you. How are you?
It's raining, but that's okay.
No, it's fine.
Because you're big top.
Yes, that's right.
Yes,
got that tent covering me. I'm going to be dry, put it that way.
And you're going to take the crowds from the Kings of Leon.
I know, I can't wait. I want to see Kings of Leon perform.
I'm not sure there's going to be time.
Oh yeah, I know, but maybe not. I can just wish them luck from here.
Yeah. Do that. So how are you feeling festival-wise? Are you up for this?
Well, I'm so up for it because this is actually my first ever festival that
is
I'm performing
really?
At. Yeah,
okay.
My first festival. So
why
I'm
have
really,
you held off so long?
Not that I've held off. I guess last year I was doing a lot of promotion in Europe and in Australia and Asia and wasn't around for the festival season, but I'm around now. So Isle of Wight, bring it on, baby.
And it's girls' night.
Yes, that's right.
But some of the wimpy boys with the rain are going to be
out. Oh yes. But you know, rain really does make a festival, but I'm hearing this is the first time it's rained in Isle of Wight.
It's normally lovely.
Oh.
Yeah, but the wellies are out now.
Yeah, it's all good.
They have a purpose. I think wellies are quite a fashion thing now anyway, so
yeah,
now they have a purpose.
Absolutely.
I'm loving the festival outfit.
Thank you very much.
Talk us
through it? Yeah, I'm wearing a bit of Dolce.
Oh,
Dolce dress.
She's
but I'm
changed.
Not. I'm not wearing this for performing. I've got a little something special for you guys.
Thank
so
you.
Yeah, well, it's, you know, it's different. It's gonna be quite cool, funky.
Okay. So it's 3 years since you went.
Since this is the third year, yes.
Okay. I'm imagining things have changed.
Yeah,
quite a lot in
things
that time.
Have changed, but I'm very happy, and it's been an amazing journey so far. I hope it continues like this, you know?
Yeah. What have been the main kind of pinch me is this happening moments?
Probably every day of my life.
Really?
Yeah, because, you know, exactly, this is happening. You know what it is? At the end of the day, I know that in this industry, anything can change and people can kind of, you can lose what you have in a second. So I'm very grateful for every opportunity that's been given to me, and I just hope that this really does continue for years to come.
Yours did seem more of a successful year when you think JLS.
JLS came from that
came
year,
from
Diana
well.
Vickers came from that year also, yeah.
Why was that?
I don't know. I guess, you know what's special about that year as well? We all really, really connected.
Mm-hmm.
We're all still in touch, which is what's really magical as well. And it was a great year, man. It was a great year.
Are you still in touch with all the judges as well?
I am, yes. I'm still in touch with all the judges. You know, it was a great year. It was the dream year, I think.
Yeah. Do you think the format will work in America as well as it's done over here?
I think so. It's much different to American Idol with how X Factor do their things and stuff. You know, each mentor has a category and it's very different. So that's why I think it would work.
And the judges?
Absolutely, of course, it's always going to work.
With no Cheryl now?
Well, no one's ever seen the footage, so I'm not sure.
Yeah.
You know, I can't really judge on that.
There's been a lot of mystery around it, actually.
Yeah, exactly.
Nicole Scherzinger, I think, will do a good job.
I mean, I think they both would have, if I'm honest. I remember when the rumours were going around of who was a judge, and I always said Nicole and Cheryl would make great judges.
Yeah. Have you spoken to Cheryl?
I haven't, no, okay. I haven't.
Like, just want to give her a hug, really.
Yeah.
All going down.
Yeah, but she's a fighter. I'm sure she's going to pick herself back up.
She's going to be just fine. Obviously, you're in the big tent tonight. If you could step out in the rain to see somebody, would it be Kings of Leon?
It would be Kings of Leon. I absolutely love them. I think they're awesome. They rock.
Yeah. Would you like to cover a Kings of Leon track?
Oh, maybe? My goodness. Why not?
Sex on Fire?
I would try my very best to. It wouldn't be as amazing as them, but I'd try my best. I'd put my little Alex stamp on it.
You've collaborated with some fairly impressive artists over in America.
I've been very lucky to have the opportunity to work with people like Neo, Pitbull, Flo Rida, even down to amazing producers. I'm very blessed. For a girl that's only had one album and who I've worked with, I have to pinch myself in that respect too, because that's kind of unheard of for a first album.
Yeah. So like you said, those pinch me
moments, it always happens. I'm always pinching myself because I'm that girl that thought it would never happen. So for this to happen, it's great. It's a lot of fun.
Big time. And what's up next for you after the big tent tonight?
Well, I go back to London, actually, because I've got something to do tomorrow for T4.
Right.
But I'm gigging throughout the summer. I've got so many other shows and stuff. I'm doing a load of festivals. I've got one in Cork that I'm headlining, Live at the Marquee. I've got one in Ireland, which is really funny. But some with Ollie Murs over the summer, too. So there's a lot going on. But I actually leave to go to Asia on Monday for 1 week to do some promotion. And then I'm back.
What's on the to-do list still? If there's, like, three things that you still need to do.
Okay. one, win a Brit.
Okay. Yeah.
I've been nominated, but never won one, and that's a dream. I guess to do would break America, and then the last to do would be to make a great album for my fans right now.
I think all of that is, is guaranteed.
Fingers and toes crossed.
Yes. Lovely to see you.
Nice to see you too. Thank you. Yes.